Today, we're going to continue our series on hosting a Gatsby site using AWS. In the first video, we stepped through setting up the basic infrastructure needed to host a site using an S3 bucket and a CloudFront distribution. In the next two videos, we added the missing pieces to make it production ready. Today, we're going to use GitHub Actions to automatically build and deploy our changes every time we make a push to our master branch. Hi, I'm Paul Sparks with Guiding Digital. Automating your build and deployment process is a critical step in increasing the efficiency and quality of your development lifecycle. In today's video, I'm going to show you the basic steps to take to implement a simple automated build and deployment process using GitHub Actions. As a starting point, I have an out-of-the-box Gatsby site that I created using the Gatsby new command. During the video, I'll go over how to set up the AWS credentials, and we'll go over how to add the GitHub action to a repo that will automatically build our application, deploy the build output to our S3 bucket, and then clear the CloudFront cache every time we push a change to our master branch. If you want to follow along with today's video, you'll want to make sure and watch my first video in the series on setting up the infrastructure in AWS before continuing. The first thing we're going to do is set up the AWS credentials. We'll use these credentials in our GitHub action to deploy to our S3 bucket and to purge our CloudFront cache. The first step is to create an IAM policy. I'm already logged into the AWS console, and so I'll navigate to the IAM section and then go to the policies section. Then I'll click the Create Policy button. From here, we need to assign the permissions that the GitHub action needs to the S3 and CloudFront service. When you're setting up your policy, I would encourage you to follow the principle of least privilege and only give your policy the bare minimum permissions that it needs. We'll first add the permissions for the S3 service. So we'll search for S3. And then we'll add four different permissions. The first is the list bucket permission. And the second is the get object permission. And the last two in the right section are the put object and delete object permissions. Next, we need to limit these permissions to our specific bucket. We'll click the add ARN link and then enter our S3 bucket name. We need to do this for two different levels, at the bucket level and at the object level. At the object level, enter the bucket name and then it's okay to actually give it access to all objects. Now we need to add the permissions for CloudFront. And so we click the add additional permissions link and then search for CloudFront. For CloudFront, it just needs a single permission, the create invalidation permission. And just like our S3 bucket, we want to limit the permission to just the distribution we want to deploy to. To find the distribution ID, we can switch back to CloudFront and then copy the distribution ID from there. Then we'll paste it in and then click add. And then we're ready to review our policy. Once you've confirmed the permissions look correct, you can give the policy a name. And then hit the Create Policy button. Next, we need to create a user and then assign our policy to that user. So we'll go to the User section and click the Add User button and give the user a name. Then we want to allow programmatic access. We check the checkbox and then go to the next step. Now we need to attach our policy we just created. So we'll search for a policy and then add it. And then click the next button a few times and click create user. You'll want to copy the access key ID and the secret access key somewhere. You'll need this in a future step. For some reason you lose it, you'll need to come back to this user and create a new credential. Now let's go to Visual Studio Code and let's add our code for our GitHub action to our repo. To add a GitHub action to a repo, first we got to create a .github folder and within that folder, create a workflows directory. And then we create our GitHub action file within that folder. The name is not important. I'm going to call mine main.yaml. Now we need to add our code for our GitHub action. I'll copy and paste a little bit at a time and then we'll review each section. If you're trying to follow along, you can pause as we go along, or I'll include a link in the video description to the completed repo. This first section I copied in just contains a basic GitHub action. You'll see on the first line, it has a name. The name is not important. You just give it any name that makes sense to you. Then it's got the on section. This is where you can configure what events and what branches you want this GitHub action to be triggered on. For the first pass, we'll trigger ours on pushes to the master branch. The next section is where we define our build steps. The first step is a default GitHub action that checks out our repository under the GitHub workspace. Next, we'll copy in the step that actually builds our application. You'll see that it runs a yarn command and then an npm run build, which would run a Gatsby build command. The next step is a step that will configure our AWS credentials. So these are the credentials we set up earlier. This is getting the AWS command line ready to run our commands. Of course, you'll notice that we don't directly hard code the access key and the other variables for security reasons. I'll show you in the next step where you can actually set these up in GitHub. Next, we run the AWS S3 sync command. This sync command will sync the contents of the public directory in our GitHub workspace with our S3 bucket. The delete flag at the end will delete any contents from the S3 bucket that no longer exists in the build output. The last step is to clear our cache after we've deployed our content to the S3 bucket. So to do that, we run the AWS CloudFront create invalidation command, and we're just going to pass it a path of /*, which will clear everything from the cache. Now let's go to our repo in GitHub, and let's go to the settings section, and we're going to add our secret values. In the left menu, go to the secrets section, and then click on the add new secret link, and then enter the secret key. The name doesn't really matter. It just needs to match what you added to the GitHub script in the repo. Then we'll add the value that we copied from the previous step. Next, we'll add the secret for the AWS secret access key. Then we'll paste in the value that we copied from the previous step. You'll want to guard this key. I'm not blurring it out because I plan on deleting the credentials right after this video. Next, we'll add the secret for the AWS region. My S3 bucket is in the US East 2 region. And then we'll add the next one for the bucket name and the last one for the CloudFront distribution ID. Now we'll switch back to Visual Studio Code and we'll push up our changes. Now we'll switch back to GitHub and then we'll go to the Actions section and we'll refresh the page and we see that our action is running. We can drill down into it and click on the Build section. And we can see the build as it progresses. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward to the end. And then we see all the steps passed. Then we can open up the browser and go to my test site. And we see that it deployed correctly. Now let's go back to Visual Studio Code. And I'm going to show you one way you can customize your script to account for a pull request. Let's say you have the scenario of on pull request, you want to build the application, but you don't want it to deploy. You can add conditional statements to the steps so that they only occur for certain events. So let me walk through how to do that. The first thing we'll do is we'll create a local Git branch. Next, I'm going to make a small change to my home page. Next, we'll modify the on section of the action to account for pull requests to the master branch. For the configuring AWS credentials step, the deploy to S3 step, and the invalidate CloudFront step, I'm going to add the if property and then indicate that I only want to run the step if it's a push event. Then I'll push my changes up to the repo again. Then I'll switch back to GitHub and then go to the pull requests tab and create a new pull request. Then we can go back to the actions tab and refresh. Then we see our action running again. I'm going to go ahead and skip to the end again. And you'll see that it ran the build step, but it skipped the deployment steps. Now let's go back to our pull request. If we go to the details of the checks, we see that the build passed. Now let's merge our pull request. And then we go back to the Actions tab and see that our build is running again. And we see that the steps are running. And I'm going to fast forward again to the end. And we see that all of our steps completed. Now if we go back to our site and refresh, we see that our change has been deployed.
In today's video, I've given you one way you can automate your build and deployment of your AWS hosted Gatsby site. In the future videos, we'll continue on the topic of automation by going over how you can automate your infrastructure deployments. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like. Make sure and subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below, and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.